We are live, audiosportsonline.com. Live for Zionsville Eagles varsity basketball. Tonight, a chilly night in central Indiana. And Lafayette Jeff is the visitor tonight to the Zionsville Eagles home gym. I'm Jay Baker, looking forward to another exciting evening, the Friday night tradition here in central Indiana. The battle on the hardwood. Wonderful tradition. Always great this time of year, and it's always nice when it's very crisp and cold as it is this evening as we await a great contest here tonight. The Zionsville Eagles enter this contest 6-3. They are 20th overall in Class 4A. Their opponent tonight, the Lafayette Jefferson varsity basketball squad, is 3-7. They're 83rd overall in 4A, and Zionsville here tonight expecting to add to that win total. Some great players that we've seen time and time again here on the floor for the Zionsville Eagle, returning lettermen like Andrew Dockich and Parker Dunchy, who we'll see in the guard position. Michael Salmon, who did an outstanding job in junior varsity a year ago, is currently on the varsity squad. Not unexpected. In fact, he played in approximately 30% of the varsity games last season. Also returning lettermen Dalton Judd, Scotty Panola, and Alex Sibla from the front line. They offer a big presence. Dalton Judd at 6 foot, Scotty Panola at 6'4", Alex Sibla at 6'4". They'll be joined on the front line by a newcomer, but a guy whose name should ring a bell with Indiana hardwood heroes. It'll be Derek Smits, the son of Rick Smits. And it's always funny to see Rick, who's a varsity assistant coach, walking around the gym because you can't help but go, "Hey, Rick Smits," as Rick towers over everyone else. We're going to rise for the national anthem, and we're looking forward to some basketball. One thing you can always look forward to with Zionsville varsity basketball is plenty of school spirit. The always rowdy student section fired up after a week of being back at school. Happy New Year to everyone from audiosportsonline.com. Lafayette Jeff downstairs announcing their starting lineup here tonight. Devin Haney, 6'1", starting at guard tonight. Keaton Hamilton will also be a starter here tonight. Peter Ripke, the 6'3" senior forward. And Tyler Buchanan also starting for the Lafayette Jeff boys basketball varsity. And now we're getting ready and excited as the Zionsville Eagles. The student section getting fired up and ready. We are just moments away. 32 minutes of basketball here live from the Eagles gym. Starting lineup being announced. Number one on your program tonight, Andrew Dockich, 6'2", 185 pounds, the starting guard. Michael Solman, 5'11", 165. He's a junior. Number 22, Dalton Judd, starting at forward here tonight, 6-foot senior. Derek Smits will start tonight at the forward position, 6'10", 220 pounds. And we'll round out the top five with Scotty Panola, 6'4", 225 pounds. He'll play forward. Some big muscle on the line here, and really enjoyed Scotty Panola's play a year ago, and he'll be one of the starters here tonight for the Zionsville Eagles. So some big names in Indiana basketball, Smits and Dockage. Smits, of course, Rick Smits, who played for the Pacers, and Dan Dockage, who was a standout for Indiana University. His son, Andrew Dockage, plays here tonight. Andrew is a senior and one of the leaders on this team. Derek Smits is in center circle, and we are getting ready for the tip and the beginning of this basketball contest. Tip is up. It is controlled by Zionsville. Dockage brings the ball down outer perimeter. Gets the ball off to Judd. They feed it now right wing to Dockage. Dockage started to drive the lane, decided to back it out. Panola inside to Smits. Smits from the foul line up. And Rick Smits, make that Derek Smits, draws first blood here. 2 points for the Eagles, who take the early lead. Methodically bringing the ball up for Jefferson is Peter Ripke. Outside shot is up, and it is no good. Rebound knocked away. Panola with a nice inside move. They knocked it out of Panola's hand. It'll be inbound by the Eagles. Dockage brings the ball in to Solomon. Michael Solomon, the junior, and Dockage, the senior, bring the ball up past the timeline. Eagles up early, 2-0 in this game. The 2-3 zone employed by Jefferson. Long shot is up, and Dockage with the three-pointer, and Andrew Dockage adds three to the Eagles' score, 5-0 here early in the first period. 6:52 to play here. Zionsville Eagles home court. Jeff in their black away uniforms. They drive the lane, does not go. Smits with the rebound. As Derek Smits back out to Smits. Smits loses the handle briefly. Gets the ball off to Dockage. Dockage and Solomon in the backcourt for the Eagles. Solomon feeds to Dockage. Dockage has an open lane. Dishes it off. Great assist and basket by Scotty Panola. His first 2 points of the evening, and the Eagles jump out to an early 7-0 lead here with 6:08 left in the first quarter. Eagles drop down into their 3-2 zone as Jeff tries to find a shot out on the perimeter, and first points of the game for them, Peter Ripke. So Jeff cuts into that lead 7-3. Coming back the other way, Dockage in the lane. Pass back out to the perimeter. Long shot by Solomon. It does not go. Smits tried to get the rebound. They're going to tie it up. Tie up inside, and possession arrow favors Jeff this time around. But Smits with some good hustle on the rebound just could not get a handle on it. Smits is a real presence, a bit of a beanpole at 220 at 6'10 frame. And his father, I believe, was a legitimate 7-footer for the Pacers. Jeff brings the ball up after the possession arrow turnover. Long shot, no go. Rebound grabbed by Jeff. Long shot, serve back up again. They're going to chase the rebound down. And Judd picks it up and will bring it up for the Eagles. 7-3 lead, enjoyed by Zionsville. They get the ball inside to Smits. Smits backs his man down, turns around. The jumper no good. Jeff controls the rebound, and the ball coming back up the other way. Jefferson now. Long ball, bomber, 2 3-pointers, makes it 7-6 in favor of the Eagles. So the Eagles now have to guard that outside perimeter as they bring the ball up. Salmon into Smits inside, and Smits can't get the shot to drop. Smits, who had position, had the layup, just could not get the ball to drop. The Eagles 7-6, and now the ball comes down the other way for Lafayette. Good defense by the Eagles. Long ball up, and the first 9 points for the Broncos all coming from the long ball, and they lead 9-7 with 4:07 left to play here in the first period. They get the ball into Panola. Panola to Salmon, back to Panola, over to Smith. Some good passing. Smith can't find the basket just yet, having some trouble getting the ball dropped. And the Eagles will control the rebound. Dockage, wide open three. Can't get it to go, and reaching over the top, I believe they're going to call the foul on Dalton Judd. Dalton's first foul, Eagles' first foul. First foul of the game with 3:46 left to play here. And Jeff, with a 9-7 lead, will inbound. Jeff brings the ball down, perimeter left. Tries to go to the baseline and travel. That was Devin Haney for Lafayette Jeff, the starter. 6'1 junior. Inbound for the Eagles. Quickly bringing the ball up court. It is Judd. He gets trapped, gets the ball off to Dockage. Dockage, long cross court pass to Salmon. Salmon gets it back out to Judd. And Judd fouled. First foul on the Broncos. Both teams with a team foul apiece. New in the game is Braden Hall. Hall in the backcourt, along with Dalton Judd. Feed the ball inside to Panola. Make that Alex Sibilla in the game. The shot is up, and it is good. And Sibilla is in and contributes early. Gets his first 2 points of the game. And this game is knotted 9-9. 2:50 left to play. First period. Eagles drop down in their 3-2. Lafayette's been pretty tough here from the perimeter. And now foul. They're going to call the offensive foul on Peter Ripke. And the Eagles will get the ball back. 9-9 the score here. As Braden Hall brings it up along with Dockage. They get the ball over to Scotty Panola. Panola drives the lane, and then Panola was fouled. That'll put Panola on the line for two. Ripke picks up a quick second foul, and that will be an overall 3 fouls for the Broncos. So Panola, first shot is up, and it is good. Panola's second shot off the mark. And the Broncos quickly back on offense. Long ball, the bomb doesn't go. The Broncos control the rebound. Once again, the bomb, it is up and it is good. That is Lucas Wallace for the Broncos. And the Broncos back out 12-10. Travel on the way up. They're going to call that one on Judd. And the Broncos will inbound. Judd will sit, and in the game is Aaron Powell. 210. And the Broncos up by a score of 12-10 after the Eagles took an early lead. Ball stolen inside. That was Cibola on the steal. Long cross-court pass, and it goes out of bounds. Broncos will inbound. And even two left in this first period. So the Eagles took an early 7-0 lead, and then the Broncos started bombing from the outside as for some adjustment to this Eagles lineup. Long shot over the top of Dockett. It's going to go out of bounds, and the Eagles will inbound. It'll be Dockett and Hall in the backcourt. And in the forecourt is Powell, along with Alex Cibola. And they'll be joined in there by Scotty Panola. Hall calls the play. Gets the ball over to Dockett. Back over to Hall. Trying to find a man cutting inside. They get the ball inside. It is up, and it is good. Alex Cibola with points from the paint. And this game is tied up 12-12 with 1:14 left to play. Driving to the basket, they're going to call the foul. Aaron Powell just drew the foul. That'll be the second team foul on the Eagles. Inbound Jeff underneath their own basket. Good defense put up by the Eagles. 1:10, the clock just a little bit slow to start here. As the Broncos set up offensively. They end up throwing the ball out of bounds. So the mystery man could not get to it. Quarren Hood, the junior, threw the ball out of bounds, and the Eagles will retain possession. Score knotted 12-12. As Dockett and Hall will bring the ball down. They feed the ball into Smits. Dockett down to Smits. Smits with the long cross-court pass. That one was almost stolen. Dockett with the wide-open three, and he drains it. Andrew Dockett. Dockett with his sixth point of the game as we are under 30 seconds now, and the Eagles up 15-12. A spirited first period. Long ball launches, and it is good. Eagles will get the final shot here of the first period, bring the ball down quickly. Hall over to Dockett. Quick feed into Panola. Dockett once again, the long three, and drills it. Andrew Dockett now with 9 points. A nice contribution from Andrew Dockett, who finishes with the final points here of the first period, and the Zionsville Eagles go to their bench with a smile of relief after an early 7-0 run. A rebound there from the Broncos, and the Eagles will go into the second period leading by a score of 18-15. Broncos got there via the three-point ball, and that's forced some defensive adjustments for the Zionsville Eagles ball club. Andrew Dockett, two-time letterman, though, a man with a mission here tonight, lead scorers with 3 in the first period. Derek Smits with 2, and Alex Cibola with 4 to round out the 18 points the Eagles now enjoy. So the Eagles will come out to lead this first half, or lead the second period, rather. Andrew Dockett will be in along with Michael Solman, Alex Cibola, Dalton Judd, and Derek Smits will round out the 5 for the Eagles. Dockett brings the ball up, calls the play. cross-court pass. Solman, left wing. Ball was just about stolen away. Let's see what the call is. Darren Collins from Lafayette Jeff with the foul. Eagles will retain possession. Judd gives the ball back to Dockage. Dockage looking for Smits underneath the basket. Wide open. Solman, corner pocket three. Couldn't get it to drop. The rebound retained by the Eagles. The quick steal and the layup. Excellent heads up there from Darian Collins for Lafayette Jeff. And the Eagles lead 18-17. Quickly back the other way. Good inside move. Dalton Judd, power move to the basket, and Judd puts up his first 2 points of the game. The Eagles still lead 20-17. Long ball outside, doesn't go anywhere. Dockage with the rebound. Dockage brings it up quickly. They feed it inside to Panola. Panola to Solman, and Solman gets points in the paint. Michael Solman with his first 2 points of the game. 22-17 now for the Eagles with 6:47 left to play. Broncos set up on their end of the court. Perimeter. Defensive pressure being applied by Judd and Solman. Feed back to the top. Drives the lane and I think they're going to call the offensive foul on Quarren Hood. Offensive foul, and the Eagles get the ball back. Four team fouls for the Broncos, two for the Eagles. The Eagles lead 22-17. 6:25 left to play here in the first half. 9 points in the first period for Andrew Dockage as he brings the ball down. Gets the ball down to Judd. Judd on the dribble. Dockage now, perimeter. Dockage feeds it down to Solman. Solman, wide open three. Can't get it to drop. They can't get position inside. Broncos with the rebound. Dockage had position, but I think Dockage drew that foul, and that will put Darian Collins on the line. So Collins with a chance for a three-point play here as the Eagles are up 22-19. Collins can put him into the 20s here with this shot, and he does. So three-point play by Collins. Dockage pretty sure that he had position. That is Dockage's first penalty of the evening. Eagles lead by two. Quick inbound. No foul, though. That was Sibilla inside, or make that Scotty Panola inside. Couldn't get the ball to drop. And I believe a foul on the transition. They're going to call it on Dalton Judd. So Judd just picked up his second foul. Judd will sit, and in is Braden Hall, number five for the Eagles. 5:40 left to play here, first half. Broncos inbound. Four team fouls, both sides, both the Broncos and the Eagles. Broncos with that perimeter ball, feed the ball inside. Smits with the block, gets the ball into the hands of Dockage. Dockage drives, the lane will go all the way, and he was fouled heavily inside. Both Dockage and the defender are okay as they go heavily to the hardwood, and that'll put Andrew Dockage on the line. That's a 15 foul for the Broncos. Very scrappy inside play from Quarren Hood, who's listed at 5'7", and may not quite be that tall, but playing with a lot of heart here tonight for the Broncos. Shot is up and good for Dockage. That is Dockage's 10th point this evening. And can't get the second shot to drop. 23-20 now for the Eagles. 3-point lead as the Broncos bring the ball down. Hall and Salmon applying the outer perimeter pressure for the Eagles. Errant pass, scooped up. That was Panola. Panola out to Salmon, back to Panola. Dokic feeds it inside. Panola drives. And nice touch as Panola gets 2 points in the paint. Gives the Eagles a 5-point lead. Jeff tries to bounce the ball off, loses the pass, scooped up by Dokic. Back the other way, Dokic with the wide open three. Thinks better of it, feeds it inside to Smits. Smits still having some trouble getting that position layup to land. And ball goes back the other way. So Smits with just a little bit of trouble here tonight inside. Only 2 points so far in this game, but good position. And timeout called on the playing surface by Lafayette Jeff. Zionsville Eagles varsity basketball home game tonight as they host Lafayette Jeff. Lafayette Jeff came in 3-7, 83rd overall in 4A, and the Zionsville Eagles 20th in 4A with a record of 6-3. A somewhat subdued student section here tonight. We usually expect some real rowdiness from those guys, so a little surprised. Got to get some fire up here from the Eagles faithful. On a cold January night, hope you're having a great new year so far. Eagles would like to extend their winning streak. That's one of their resolutions. As they break the huddle, it'll be Salmon in with Smits, Hall. Dokic remains out there along with Scotty Panola. Panola and Dokic, the seniors. As the Broncos bring the ball up, trailing by 5. Good perimeter pressure applied by the Eagles. 2-point insider, that was Lucas Wallace. Hall brings it down, dishes it off to Salmon. Salmon back to Hall, Dokic, right perimeter. Dokic with a nice feed inside to Panola, and Panola gets points. Scotty Panola now with 7 points here in the first half. Eagles lead 27-22. Broncos have had some trouble breaking that outer perimeter. Rebound by Smits, and the Eagles will be bringing it up. Dokic looked for the quick transition opening, couldn't find it. They pull up now. Hall with the ball over to Salmon. Dokic now started to drive, lost the handle, and ball's out of bounds. Broncos bring the ball up, trailing by 5, 27-22, 2:57 left to play here in the second period. Broncos with that perimeter ball throughout the game. That's been pretty much their go-to. They finally drive the lane, and they're going to call the foul. Michael Solman drew his first foul. And that will be the Eagles' 5th overall foul. And the Broncos will inbound under their basket. Still trail by 5. Having a little bit of trouble getting the ball in and finally just caroms it off the stomach of Michael Solman, who was not particularly happy about that. You don't oftentimes see that play, but I guess that's kind of what they do as the Broncos now regroup, and they just warned him. Salmon spoke to the ref, and now the ref is speaking to the two players involved. The ref actually had a smile on his face. So I'm going to guess, yeah, not the preferred play. The Broncos finally get the ball in. Once again, working that perimeter, drives down, dishes the ball off. Back up outside the three-point arc. Eagles with a tough D here, 2:32. Finally, the drive doesn't go anywhere, dishes it back out. The drive in the lane, up and good. A good move to the basket. That was Lucas Wallace. Eagles now trail by three, or actually lead by three. So they get the ball up to Mann. Mann in the game. Salmon. Back to Mann. That's Hall. Hall now. Nice feed inside to Panola, and Panola drew the foul. Make that Alex Sibilla drew the foul. And that should put Sibilla on the line. That is a 16 foul for the Broncos. And Sibilla converts. Alex Sibilla, the junior, 6'4", 200 pounds. Good physical presence for the Eagles, and a good shot here tonight. Misses his second one, but has 5 points overall here in the first half. Just under 2 minutes as the Broncos bring the ball down. Broncos pull up, jumper, goes nowhere, rebound by Dockage. Dockage always quick on the transition, looking for a good transition break to the basket as the Eagles go into their offense. Dockage drives, gets the ball off. Solomon wide open, three, can't get it to go. Broncos with the rebound, and Solomon, I believe, reached in. So Salmon drew his second foul. He'll sit. And in the game is Jake Mann. So it is Mann and Hall, along with Panola and Sibilla. Dockage rounds out the five. Broncos try and get the ball inside. Almost stolen away. Sibilla, quick move. Sibilla stepped on the line, though, after he got the ball. So Jefferson will inbound. They trail by four with 1:14 left to play here in the first half. Jefferson as the clock ticks towards a minute left to play here in the first half. Good exterior D being played on that zone there by Dockage and Panola. Seconds, and the Broncos still looking for an open man. Good pressure being applied by Dockett, who almost got the steal. Finally, they drive in. Panola with the rebound, but once again couldn't get full possession of it. Stepped on the line, and the Broncos will inbound. Good hustle from Alex Sibilla inside, but just couldn't keep the handle. 37.9 seconds, the Broncos inbound. Good D being applied by Hall. Also, Mann is in there, and Dockage as well. Under 30 now. Broncos seemingly trying to play for that final shot. They trail by four. Broncos have hung in there. Finally get the ball off, and he's stripped away by Mann. Mann with the outlet pass. Long pass. Nice over-the-top play from Alex Sibilla following the nice feed from Dockage, who put the ball up on the rim. They're going to count it. Last-second shot for Lafayette Jeff. That was Devin Haney. The ball drops. And at halftime, the Zionsville Eagles enjoy a 30-26 lead, but a nice flurry to add 2 points at the very end for Lafayette Jeff. Lafayette Jeff came in 3-7, 83rd overall in 4A. Zionsville Eagles with a tough squad this year, 20th in 4A. They are 6-3, and the Eagles started out 7-0 in this game. Broncos held tough, and they trail by 4 at halftime. So we'll take a halftime break here at Zionsville Eagles Gym, and we'll be back. I'm sure there will be some type of hard-hitting halftime entertainment, as there oftentimes is here. And we'll be back with another exciting 16 minutes of basketball here live. Zionsville Eagles varsity basketball on audiosportsonline.com. both the coaching staffs and the teams out following the three-minute horn as they warm up here for the second half. Lafayette Jeff Broncos came into this contest 3-7. The Zionsville Eagles 6-3. Eagles with 30 points in the first half. Andrew Dockage leads. Zionsville scores with 10 points. Scotty Panola was 7, as well as Alex Cibola was 7 points. Michael Salmon with a pair of points. Dalton Judd with 2 points. And Derek Smits, who has had good position underneath but has struggled just a little bit, getting points in. The 6'10 sophomore with 2 points in the first half, giving the Eagles an overall score of 30 points. The Broncos closed the initial 7-0 run to start off the first quarter with a series of long balls and ended up going up 9-7. And the three-pointer has been pretty much the key to the Broncos hanging tough in this game, just trailing by 4 points. Zionsville Eagles varsity coach Sean Busick and the varsity assistant coaches Andrew Laird, Henry Nolan, and Rick Smits. So we're getting ready to put another 8 minutes up on the clock. We'll commence this third period. The Eagles getting ready to break their huddle at the bench. And here in the second half, we will see Derek Smits along with Scotty Panola, Andrew Dockage, Dalton Judd, and Michael Salmon will round out the top five. So the Broncos begin with their inbound and the third period, the second half, underway. Broncos go back to that perimeter and a foul away from the ball. They're going to end up calling that one on Dalton Judd. That's Judd's third foul. Judd, unfortunately tonight, been a little bit foul prone. As the Broncos inbound. Broncos long three, and they get it to drop. That is Peter Ripke, the 6'3 senior. 30-29 for the Eagles, their first touch here of the second half. They get the ball into Smith. Smith with the turnaround, can't get it to go. Underneath with the rebound is Dalton Judd. And Judd is fouled, and that'll put him on the line. Judd with 2 points in the first half. And Judd's first foul shot up, and he made it look easy. Dalton Judd with the first points for the Eagles here in the second half. Both of the free throws are good, and the Eagles lead now at the 32-29 as the Broncos bring the ball up. The drive down the lane, ball almost stripped away. Back out to the perimeter. Broncos drive the lane, can't get it to go, kick it back out. 3-2 defensive zone being played by the Eagles. Long ball up, and it is good. 32-32 all here, 6:44 left to play, third period, as Dockage brings the ball up. Over to Salmon. Salmon gets a little bit of help, dishes it back to Smits. Long three from Dockage, can't get it to go. Salmon almost with the rebound. Dockage steals it away on the transition. Ball won't go. And finally, after a flurry, let's see what the call is. Scotty Pinola with the foul. That's his first foul. And the first team foul here for the Eagles. Make that the second team foul here in the second half. Broncos. Score tied, 32 all. They almost lose the handle. Defensive pressure being applied by Dokic and Pinola. Still having trouble getting inside that Eagle defense. The shot is up and no good. Dokic with the rebound. And quickly the Eagles come down the opposite end. Judd over to Pinola. They feed it back down to Pinola in the lane. Good inside move. And Scotty Pinola with 2 points here in the second half. 9 overall for Pinola. Eagles up by 2, 34-32. The jumper, 15-footer, won't go. And the foul on the rebound. They're going to call that one on Tyler Buchanan. And coming into the game is Quarren Hood, the 5'7 junior. Plays with a lot of hustle. Bringing the ball up is Dokic calling the play. He and Solomon are in the backcourt. Smits, Pinola, and Judd in the front court. Quick dish down to Dokic. Dokic in the corner by himself, dishes it back. Get it inside to Smits. Smits can't get the ball to drop, and they lost the handle on the rebound. Good hands in there by Pinola, but he just couldn't bring it down. Broncos now back on offense. Trail by 2. 4:32. Time's gone quickly in this. And a quick feed inside and shot up and good. That is Tyler Buchanan. Dokic feeds it off to Smits. Smits with the layup. Can't get the ball to drop. Smits gets his own rebound. Gets it up. Won't go. And the foul inside. I think they're going to call that against Lucas Wallace of the Broncos. Darian Collins draws the foul, and that'll put Smits on the line. So Smits having some trouble scoring inside. A lot of height there, trying to build on that experience as the sophomore will shoot his first free throw. And it is up, and it is good. Braden Hall comes in the game for the Eagles as Derek Smits gets ready to shoot his second free throw. It is up and no good. Sibilla will come in and Smits will sit. Broncos bring it in. 4:13 left to play here in the third period. They trail by 2, 36-34. Wide open 3, but he's not going to go. Feeds it back up to the top. They're looking for a cut underneath. Tough inbound. Alex Sibilla inside, providing some inside muscle for the Eagles. Sibilla, Dokic, and Pinola inside. Nice turnaround jumper, and the Broncos tie it up 36 all. Dokic, 10 first half points. Back to Judd. Judd now tries to set something up inside to Pinola. Pinola shot up and it is good. Actually, it was Sibilla with points. And Sibilla gets his first 2 points of the second half. Eagles up 38-36. Broncos working that perimeter. Tough D being applied, and Sibula steals the ball away. And the Eagles will bring the ball down. Quick pass over to Hall. Hall feeds it back over to Judd. Feed inside, and he got fouled on the way to the basket. That was Scotty Pinola. Nice move, and Pinola will be on the line. Now they're saying the foul was on Pinola. So offensive foul on Scott Pinola. That was his second of the game. Three team fouls for both the Eagles and the Broncos. And boy, I just didn't see it that way, and I'm sure Scotty didn't either. As the Broncos trail by two. Closing in on the two-minute mark here. Steal by Dockage. Dockage with the ball, brings it down, feeds it up, and just couldn't get a hold of the handle at the very end was Scott Pinola. And the ball sails out of bounds. But a good feed by Dockage. Right at the two-minute mark for the Broncos. 38-36 in this third period. The drive down the lane, long cross-court pass, almost went back over the timeline. Broncos now settle back down into their offense. Hall and Pinola providing the pressure. Long ball is up, and it is good, and the Broncos take a second-half lead here, 39-38, with 1:28 left to play here in the third period. Hall dishes it back out to Dockage. That was Dalton Judd. Open three, but he didn't go. Dockage, good ball handling, feeds it off to Hall. Back up to Dockage. Wide open now from Judd, and Judd drains the three. So Dalton Judd, 5 points here in the second half. Broncos, 49 seconds, set up offensively. Broncos staying on that perimeter. And it has been the three ball that's kept him in this game. That is Judd and Hall with the defensive pressure. And now the foul. They're going to put the foul on Braden Hall. That's his first. And the Eagles' fourth foul here in the second half. Inbound. Once again, the Broncos look for an opening. 24 seconds as they will set up the play for these final points right at the timeline. Back. Pressure being applied by Judd. Now the drive won't go. Rebound, though, could not be contained. And the Broncos will have another go at it. 5 seconds left to play. They're going to have to put it up. They do. And they sink it right before the buzzer sounds. A nice three-pointer there from Quarren Hood. And that will give the Broncos a 42-41 lead to finish up this third period. So the Eagles trail by one. Zionsville Eagles open with an 18-point first period, a 12-point second period, and they score another 11 points here in the third period. The Broncos open up with a 15-point first period, an 11-point second period, and end up putting 14 points up, make that 16 points here. Good offensive performance to actually lead heading into the final frame here at the Zionsville Eagles home gym. Dockage with 10 points in the first period has been cold here in the second half. leading scorer here in the second half has been Dalton Judd. He's got 5 points. So Dockage will inbound to either Judd or Salmon here as we commence the final period of play. Also in the game is Smits and Panola. Make that Sibilla. Dockage, number one on the jersey, dishes it off. Ball in and out, rebound by the Broncos. Broncos with a one-point lead. Trying to set up a methodical offense here. Judd with the defensive pressure. Smits inside applying the pressure. And the Broncos. Shot won't go, but they get their own rebound. Aggressive play. Broncos now milking this one-point lead. They get the ball inside. Defensive pressure being applied by Smits to kick it back out. Long ball up. It won't go. Rebound, though, stripped away. That was Sibilla. Had his hand on it, but couldn't bring the ball in. Another long ball there by Darian Collins. And that gives a four-point advantage. The biggest lead tonight enjoyed by the Broncos. Dockage feeds it inside to Smits. Smits tried to get it off to Salmon. The ball go out of bounds, but the Eagles will retain possession. So Dockage will inbound. Panola in. Sibilla out. Judd and Salmon on the wings. Dockage launches the three, and Dockage with his first points, 3 points to be exact, here in the second half. And the Eagles just trail by one now here, 45-44, 6:13 left to play. Judd and Salmon with the pressure on the outside. Dockage and Panola. Quick pass inside. Ball will not drop. Dockage with the rebound. And the Broncos blew an opportunity there as Dockage brings the ball up and he'll get fouled. Dockage got fouled trying to set that play up. And that was Lucas Wallace with the foul. 14 fouls each for the Eagles and the Broncos here as Dockage will inbound under their own basket. Gets the ball into Judd. Judd feeds it down to Panola. Panola up and back. They're going to call a tie-up on that one as Panola just could not get position. And the possession arrow favors the Broncos. So the Broncos inbound. Leading 45-44, 5:37 left to play here in the fourth period. Broncos have certainly picked up the intensity here in the second half. Eagles perimeter defense being applied by Salmon and the ball stripped away by Dockage. Dockage brings the ball up. Judd drives the lane, can't get it to go, and let's see what the call is inside. Judd will go to the line. Foul was inside against the Broncos. Quarren Hood drew the foul. And that will put Dalton Judd on the line for 2 shots. First one is up and it is good. So Judd here with 8 points. This could be his 9th and could give the Eagles a lead. Second shot is up and won't drop. Score remains knotted, 45 all. Broncos, 5 minutes left to play here in the game. Score tied, 45-45. the pull-up jumper, and boy, where did that one go? Salmon with the quick steal. Salmon drives, and Salmon was fouled on the way to the basket. Salmon will go to the line for two. Broncos not agreeing with that one. Peter Ripke thought he had position inside. Ripke went to the floor, and Salmon will go to the line. Salmon with two shots can give the Eagles a lead. Misses the first one. Salmon with 2 points in the first half. And Salmon's second shot in and out and will not drop. Score remains tied, 45 all, as the Broncos bring it up. Salmon and Judd applying the pressure and timeout called on the court. So the Broncos reset their offense. Both teams get a chance to catch a breather here with 4:45 left to play in the game. And the score is tied, 45 all. 16 fouls for the Lafayette Jefferson Broncos and 4 team fouls for the Zionsville Eagles. Second half points so far. 3 points for Andrew Dokic. 6 for Dalton Judd. 2 for Scott Panola. Smits with 1 point and Alex Cibola with a pair of points. Cibola and Panola, 9 points overall in this game. And Dokic leads Zionsville scorers with 13. The Broncos certainly have upped the intensity here in the second half. And the Eagles will have to respond here as this game is knotted 45 all. Broncos with the ball set up on offense. Salmon with the defensive pressure. Judd, Dokic, Smits with the inside pressure. As Judd comes out along with Salmon to apply the outer perimeter pressure. Drive, the lane, the feed, and they'll put him on the line as I think Salmon put his hand on the wrist of Tyler Buchanan. So Salmon draws the foul, and this is a possible 3-point play by the Broncos. So Smits leaves the game, and Cibola comes in. Shot is up, won't go. Rebound, though, controlled by the Broncos. Pull-up jumper is good, and the Broncos with a quick flurry of points, and they now lead 49-45. So the Eagles looking for some points on the other side. And Dokic was fouled. And that will put Dokic on the line. So Dokic can cut into that 4-point lead by the Broncos. Dokic's first shot is up and it is good. ...49-46, the Broncos lead the Eagles. Dokic's second shot is up and it is good. 15 total points now for Dokic. 2-point lead for the Broncos as they set up offensively. They try to drive the lane. And let's see who drew the foul. Alex Cibola, who extended his leg at the last minute on the drive, and they'll call Cibola for the foul. Eagles now with 6 fouls here in the second half. And they're going to call another foul inside. Cibola draws a foul, his second foul. And now bonus time for both teams. with a two-point lead. Puts the Broncos on the line, shooting foul shots. It'll be Tyler Buchanan. So Buchanan breaks 50 for the Broncos. And second shot will not go. Rebound by Panola. Panola with the ball, feeds it down to Dockage. Dockage wide open lane, goes in, feeds it off, gets it off to Sibilla. They kick it back out to Dockage. Hall and Judd in the game. Judd drives, kicks it back out to Hall. Hall with the wide open three. Shot will not go. Rebound by Jeff, and they try and contain him. Can't get it. They bring the ball down. Shot won't go, though, and rebound, Panola. So Panola feeds it off to Dockage. Quick feed into Judd. Judd with a nice layup. And Dalton Judd, two more points, and they came at a good time. Broncos lead by one now. 50-49, 2:48 left to play here in the final frame. Broncos have been spirited here tonight on the road. And they've come out with some extra oomph here in the second half. Near steal by Panola. Panola can't keep the handle, though. And the Broncos will re-inbound. 2:35. The Broncos have a one-point lead here. Judd applying the pressure. And off the hand of Judd, Broncos will bring it back in. Ripke tries to put the ball in past Dockage, finally gets it in. 2:33 left to play. Broncos trail, actually lead by one, as Hall puts the pressure on outer perimeter. Broncos try to set up a cut to the basket. Judd applies the perimeter pressure. Ball fed inside, and the layup is good. That is Tyler Buchanan. So Buchanan gives the Broncos a three-point lead. Dockage drives in, tries to feed the ball off to Panola. Eagles do retain possession, though. Long three won't go. Rebound. Partially controlled. They're going to tie it up, and the possession arrow should favor the Eagles. Let's see what the call is. The Broncos called a timeout, tried to call a timeout in time to retain possession. Let's see what the official call is going to be at the bench, as both coaches pleading their case to the officials. They're going to say that the timeout occurred in time to retain possession. That should have been a tie-up, but it was certainly very close as the Broncos were calling for a timeout. They get it, and the Broncos still lead this one by a score of 3, 52-49. So a minute 50, and the Eagles now are going to have to play with some intensity to try and get this ball back, as the Broncos are putting a scare into the 6-3 Eagles here tonight on a cold Friday night in January at Zionsville. Broncos will inbound. They get the ball in. Pressure being applied, full court pressure by Dockage and Hall. Broncos get the ball across the timeline, a minute 39 left to play. Broncos with a three-point lead. Broncos keeping the ball on the perimeter, nursing that three-point lead, forcing now some extra defensive pressure to be applied. That is Panola, Hall, and Dockage on the outside. Finally, they feed the ball in and rebound. Good positioning and a timely two-pointer there from Tyler Buchanan. Five-point lead now by the Broncos. Dockage brings the ball down. Quick feed in the corner to Judd. Back to Dockage. Dockage backs his man down, gets two. So Andrew Dockage And timeout being called by Zionsville. So full timeout being called. The scenario is as follows. 57 seconds. A timely two there from Dockage. But the Eagles still trail by four, and the Broncos will inbound. So the Broncos went from being tough to being very aggressive here in the second half. And the second half aggression has led now to a four-point lead here in clutch time with 57 seconds left to play here in the fourth quarter. Zionsville Eagles, 6-3 tonight. And they are doing everything they can to claw their way back from this one. Scotty Panola, Judd, Salmon, Hall, and Dockage remain on the court in the white jerseys for the Eagles. Broncos will inbound. And the possibility of a quick foul here on the inbound. Broncos having a little bit of trouble getting the ball in. They do. Ball almost stolen away by Dockage. Good hustle. And on the transition, the Broncos try and get to the basket. Salmon, I think, unfortunately, will draw the foul inside. Salmon does. That's the eighth team foul for the Eagles, fourth team foul for Salmon, fourth individual foul for Salmon. And that will put the Broncos on the line. Lucas Wallace here will shoot. His shot, first shot, does not go. 48.6 seconds, four-point lead. Make that a three-point lead enjoyed by the Broncos. 54-51. Wallace, his second shot. It is good. So now a four-point lead enjoyed by the Broncos. Quickly up the forecourt. Dockage brings the ball down quickly. Dockage draws the foul, and Dockage will go to the line. So Wallace stood there flat-footed. Dockage with the aggressive move, gets the advantage, and Dockage now can put some points on the board here for the Eagles. So two key free throws here for Andrew Dockage, who leads Zionsville scorers with 17 total points. Dockage's first shot is up, and it is good. Score now 55-52. And Dockage here can make this a two-point game. Second shot is up, and it is good. And indeed, that is the scenario as the Broncos bring the ball in, leading 55-53. Quick long court pass, though, is up and good. Quick inbound from the Eagles. Salmon brings the ball up quickly down to Judd. Judd with the quick three, can't get it to go. They can't get the rebound inside, and the Broncos bring it down. Transition. And unfortunately, score is up, and it is good. 25 seconds, a six-point lead enjoyed by the Broncos. Long ball from Salmon is up, and it is good. Timeout Eagles. So Salmon breathes some life here into the Eagles. Salmon with a clutch three-pointer, and with 20.1 seconds remaining in this game, the Eagles still cling to some hope. A three-point lead here enjoyed by the Jefferson Broncos. So Lafayette Jeff pouring it on here in the second half. And the Broncos went from a who are these guys to a team that leads 59-56. 20.1 seconds left here in the Zionsville Eagles home gym. Salmon with a clutch three-pointer there to close the gap 59-56. Broncos will inbound. It is Hall, Judd, Dockage, Salmon, and Panola. Broncos having some trouble inbounding now. Dockage with some pressure. They finally get the ball down, and Hall reaches in and will foul. And that'll put the Broncos on the line. Shooting will be Lucas Wallace, the 6-foot senior. 17.2 seconds, 3-point lead. And Wallace can extend that lead here with two shots. Wallace's first shot in and out. Dockage quickly up the floor, feeds it corner to Judd. Back to Salmon. Salmon with the long three. It won't go. It won't go, and the quick foul on the rebound. Salmon did what he could. He was in position for the long ball, launched it, and couldn't get it to drop. Dalton Judd with the quick foul. And that puts the Broncos back on the line. Peter Ripke, the 6'3" senior. And timeout called. Always a chess match at the very end of almost every basketball game. Most coaches will not go down without a fight. And that is certainly the case with Sean Bussick, who has watched his Zionsville Eagles struggle against a very aggressive visitor tonight, the Lafayette Jeff varsity basketball team that came in here 3-7. Eagles, who led 30-26 at the half, now find themselves trailing 59-56 with 7.6 seconds. Ripke will be on the line for the Jefferson Broncos. And another timeout called. Apparently, yes, timeout is called. An attempt to ice Peter Ripke, the senior. And the refs keeping pretty good control of this game here at the very end as a lot of activity back and forth. The Eagles have conserved as much of this clock as they can. A tall order. They'll have to hope that Ripke misses his shot. And maybe they can set up for another quick three on the other end. So the Eagles break the huddle with Mann, Dockage, Judd, Salmon, and Hall. And now Ripke will get the basketball. Ripke's first shot up and no good. So the Eagles still with a 3-point window. Ripke, this is an important shot here. Ripke's shot is up and it is good. 4-point window for the Eagles. Dockage quickly brings the ball up. Dockage drives the lane. Can't get the ball to drop. Ripke with the rebound and Dockage with the foul. Still 2 seconds left. And that could have been the ball game. Dockage, though, with plenty of hustle. And Dockage has led this team. Dockage with 19 points total. And Dockage has done everything except for launder the towels here tonight. But the Eagles probably going to step away from this one with a loss. As Peter Ripke for the Broncos puts the ball up. And this one will put the ball game away as the Broncos. 62 points here to the Eagles, 56. Quick inbound to Hall. Hall at the buzzer, can't get the ball to drop. And the Eagles go down tonight, so the Eagles will drop 2-6-4. The Lafayette Jeff Broncos will improve to 4-7. Good basketball game here tonight. The Eagles could not prevail, though, and they will go down 62-56. Hope you enjoyed Eagles varsity basketball live from Eagles Gym for AudioSportsOnline.com. I'm Jay Baker. Have a great evening.